It's wonderful to see this many people here. You know, we have a rally every third Saturday, a Mass at St. Peter's, and we march over to the abortion clinic. We'd sure love to see all of you over there.
Yeah.
You know, we usually run about 40 to 50 people, but if we could run a couple of hundred, you know, it would be wonderful. So just put that in your thoughts and say, third Saturday, St. Peter's, Mass at 8 o'clock, then we march over to the abortion clinic. We say all the decades of the rosary. We walk back saying the chaplet, divine mercy. Then we have benediction, and then we have fellowship. So I hope all of you will come. I think most of you know about Helpers of God, Precious Infants. But just briefly to go over how we happen to be part of it. We used to come down, we've been coming down for years and years to the abortion clinics. We've marched at all the hospitals, we did lots of things for years and years, but we never were really organized. And then we started talking about having a Center for Life, which we have because of all of the things that Teresa has done. But that was our goal. We wanted to have a Center for Life. So we started praying every time we get together. Every Saturday we would pray that we had some way to start something. Somebody from New Haven came over to us and he said, why don't you join Helpers of God's Precious Infants? And we said, well, what is that? They said, well, they have a chapter down in New Haven. And they said, Monsignor Riley started this years and years ago, and he has started it in Brooklyn, New York, and now it is worldwide. So anyhow, I think everybody is here. Barbara is one of them down there, Barbara Burkhardt, and Bill.
Hey.
Bill Sirkowski, where is he? Somewhere here.
Yeah.
There's Bill, he's hiding. The three of us got together anyhow, and we went down to New Haven. We found out what it was all about. And we went through all of the things they told us to do. We got legalized and we started the Helpers of God's Precious Infants here. And it's been many years now that we've been doing this. I give Bill some credit this time around because he went through all of the machinations it takes to get a Mass at the cathedral. And it isn't easy. There's a lot of things to do and a lot of people to go through. And sometimes the church is the easiest one to work with. But he did a great job. We were kind of messed up this morning as far as time was concerned, because it would have been better if we had a 10 o'clock Mass and everything would have filled in. But the people at the cathedral insisted upon a 9 o'clock Mass. That's what goofed up our timing. But nevertheless, we're all here, and it's wonderful that everybody is pro-life and out there, and I think this thing is going to grow and grow. All kinds of good things have been happening to us this last week. We had St. Luke's, we had a dedication by the Archbishop of our place over there that we're going to be using as part of St. Gerard's. And then we also had a blessing at St. Gerard's Center on Maple Street, blessing of the ultrasound machine. So everything is growing and getting better. You know, Helpers of God's Precious Infants, what we do, we are mainly out there to show the community that we are against abortion. That we are, we give a loving presence to everybody in the community. We show the abortionists that we don't like what they're doing, and yet we, out there, we're praying for them. We're praying for their conversion. We're praying for the people that are bringing their babies there to be killed. We pray for all the infants. And you know, as John and Mary were at the cross, Jesus died, he had somebody there with him. But these little babies are dying. And it's part of the whole scene that Jesus and the babies are one, and that we are there to be witnesses as John and Mary were. And so that we are that presence before all the neighborhood. And the abortionists and all the other people, we are there for their or peaceful presence and to witness and be prayerful for all concerned. Then we have the sidewalk ministers that approach the people and give them literature. And you know, a lot of the people that are coming there, they don't have very much idea of what they're doing. All they know is they have a baby that they want to get rid of. They don't know all the things that are happening. So the sidewalk ministers are there to show them and give them information that they should have. Of course, when we have this ultrasound machine, we will have more of that, because then we can show the women the baby in their womb, and that turns a lot of them around. We do have many turnarounds, probably more than we realize, but we have people coming back and saying they changed their mind. We probably have a lot more of them that don't come out, but they changed their minds. So we are that presence before the neighborhood, before the people. And you know, as we give them the literature and we tell them, we give them spiritual support, and we only, not only pray for them, but we pray for all the people concerned. I just wanted to share something with you. You know, some of us aren't too young anymore. Sometimes it's hard to get out there. But I have this little thing from Mother Teresa, and I think it's very apropos. It says, always keep in mind that your skin will wrinkle, your hair will turn gray, days will turn into years, but what is truly important never changes. Your strength, your conviction is ageless. Your spirit is the feathering of a cobweb. Behind every achievement, there is another challenge. While you are alive, feel completely alive. If you miss what you used to do, then start doing it again. Do not live your life looking at yellowing photographs. Continue even when others expect you to abandon what you do. Do not let the iron that is in you become rusty. Instead of being pitied, have people respect you. When you become, because of your age, you cannot run, then trot. When you cannot trot, then walk. When you cannot walk, use a cane. But never, never stop.
All right.